Hello everyone, welcome back to the video series of the object oriented programming with Java. Our today's topic for this particular video, that is a file class, random access file and reading a data from the web. I am an instructor, Mr. Ankit Patel. So let's start the first topic, that is a file class. So here the file class, the class that represent the file and the directory path name in an abstract manner. Now suppose if you want to get the all the properties of the file, then you can easily get through using the file class, right? So that is the main purpose of the file. Suppose if you want to get the name of the file and that name you want to use in the Java. Now you want to check the given name of the particular file, that is a file or a directory is there. Now you want to check that type of syntax, then you can easily use the file class. So here the file class has the several method for working with the directory and file, such as a creating a new directory or file, deleting and renaming a directory or the file, or listing the content of the directory, etc. So for that we require different types of method of the file class. So let's see what are the different method available in the file class. So there are the several method available in the file class. Even all these method I will show you with the examples. So first of all, let's discuss about the what are the different method. So you can see here the first method, that is a get name is there. You can easily get the name of the file, then get parent, then return the path of the parent directory. If null, return that does not exist. If any no other parent directory is there, then it will return a null. Get absolute path, that will return all the exact path, like C drive, which folder is there, and which in folder if contain another folder is there, so that will contain all the absolute path. Now get path, that will return only the name of the folder and that particular path. So this return the path of the file. Is absolute, this return the in the form of the boolean, right? In the form of the boolean, is if a particular path is absolute or not, that we can check the different property of the file, like the file is read, can we read the file, can we write the file. So that can we have the two methods that can read, that will return the true if the user can grant the permission for the read of that particular file, otherwise it will return a false. Same for the if can write is also there. Last modify, this will return the in the form of the long integer value, it will return. This will not return the date, because the return type is not in the form of the date, the return type in the form of the integer. So suppose if you want to just read the date, then you can, you need to just convert it into the date. Then length, that is length will return the size of the file. So these are the different method available in the file class, and I will also explain all these method with the examples. Now next topic, that is a random access file. Now here random access file means what? So normally up to now, if you are talking about the file input stream, file reader class, file output stream, file writer class is there, using that particular path you can read a specific file or you can write the data. But where you can write? You can write only at the end of the file. Suppose if you are writing any particular file, that file you can only write at the end of the file, or you can replace that particular file. Same as for the reading. Now you are read the data, the reading of the file is start from the first character of the file. Now here you want something different, like suppose if you want to read the data from the second line, to read the data from the third line, if you want to write something onto file after the fifth character, after the 10th character. So this type of, you want to set that particular file pointer, you can use using the concept that is called as an random access file. And one more advantage of the random access file is, here there is no requirement of the reader and writer. There is only one single class that is required to reading and writing purpose. We need to pass this mode of the, which mode you want to open the file, in a read mode, in a write mode, or in a read write mode. So that's why we don't need to create the two different objects. Like if you are talking about the file reader and writer, first we create the file reader object, then we create the, for writing purpose we need to create the object of the file writer. So in random access file you can create only one object, using that particular object you can read and write the data onto the file. So let's discuss more about this particular random access file. So this class is used for reading and writing to the random access file. Now it's behave like a large array of byte, right? Like in array, you can easily read and write the data. There is a cursor implies to array call as file pointer. That's I already told you. Can set that file pointer. You can easily see in the file, or you are writing in a Word, writing in a notepad. That file pointer are how you can write the file pointer is move accordingly. Now you can set that particular pointer by using the random access file. So here there is a cursor implies that call an array called the file pointer. By moving the cursor, we do the read and write operation, and we can seek method. We can use a seek method. The seek method is used to set the particular file pointer in the random access file. So it set the file pointer offset and measure from the beginning of the file at which the next read or write. So you need to just count where you want to set the file, because the counter is start from the first character of the file. Now if you want to set the fifth character, so the fifth character we need to count from the first character of the file. Okay, I will show you all this concept with the programming also, so don't worry about it. This is just a theoretical concept of the random access file, and I will explain all this program in this particular video. So next topic, that is reading a data from the wave. Now till now we are reading this data from our system, from our computer system, where the notepad file is there, Word file is there. You can easily read that particular data. But now if you want to make a such a program that you want to read the data from the web, like there is one Google link is there, one your website is there, in particular website you want to read that particular file, then you can easily read the data by using the reading the data from the web. How we can read this data from the web? So let's discuss about it. So first of all, reading the data from the local file on a computer or the file server, you can also access the data from the file that is on the web, that I have already told you, if you know the file URL. So for that you require exact URL, not just ankit.com is there, not just google.com. You need to write down just protocol name https://, then //, we are using a www.google.com/ the name of the file, then you can read the data. So we require exact URL, not the normal URL. Just write down anki.com, it can easily read the data. So this is not just like, so now next, for example, suppose the link is that www.google.com/index.html is there. So is the URL for the file index.html. So what is our file name? That is index.html. Google.com, it is not our file name. This is just a locator is there. So locate on the Google web server. When you enter the URL in the web browser, the browser server send the data to your browser, and which render the data graphically. But for an application program to read the data from the URL, you first need to create the URL object using the java.net.url class. So here you need to import one package that is called a java.network package is there, class with this constructor. So one public URL is there, that constructor you can easily just create the URL for the particular link that you want to read the data. So again, I will also explain this topic by using the programming. So without wasting so much time, let's start the programming. Now in this session, I will show you the three example of the first one, that is a file class, next that is a random access file, and the last one, then how to read the data from the web. So first of all, I will see you the example of the file class. So for the file class, you can see the example over here. So file class, we need to create the just object of the file. File F1, that is equals to new file, and I am passing the object of the, whatever the file name that you want to just see the property of the file, that is a.txt is there. Then just I am using all the different method of the file class. That is the first one, that is F1.getName. We are just getting the name of the file. Here the file name is a.txt, that will return the A. Then get the path. So this will return the path of the file. Get absolute path, that will return the what is the exact path, like which drive is there, which folder is there. Get parent, then the file is exist or not, can write, can read, right? Then F1 is directory or not. If you want to check whatever you pass in argument. If it is directory, then it will return a true. I will see you in the example also. If it is a file, is the absolute path, last modify, and the size of the path. So let's run this program so that you can easily understand. I am just compiling this particular file, javac demo.java, and the java demo. Sorry, this is not a demo. Our class name is javac file class is there dot java and java file class. So you can see the output. The first output, that is the name of the file, that is a.txt. Path, that is a.txt. This will return only the index path. The absolute path, this will return the V drive in a J folder. My file is there, a.txt is there. Is there any parent file is there? So this will return a null. So here they say that the file is exist or not. If it is exist, then this will print exist. Is it writable? Yes. Is it readable? Yes. It is not a directory because I have passed the file. It is a normal file. It is not an absolute path. We have not passed the absolute path like CV drive. Suppose if you are passed V colon J colon A dot txt, then this will return the absolute path. Last modify, this will return in the form of the long, not in the form of the date. Now suppose if you want to exact date of that particular path, you just need to create the object of the date class and in argument just pass this value. So this will return the date, exact date and time. Now then the size of the file, that is a 17 byte. Now suppose if you are passing over here the J, that is our folder name. So let's see what will be the output over here. I am just run it again. So here the file, but you can see here there is no any kind of file is available, so it will create the J file, right? So you need to just create a one folder in that particular path, then you can just write down the name of that particular path. So this will return in the form of the folder. So hope you understand this particular example of the file class. I have explained all these files. So in program, this file class mostly we are using check the program that particular file is exist or not. If it is directory, then list out the different file on that particular directory. So now next program, that is for the random access file. Now here the random access file, as I told you that in a random access file, you can perform both the operation by using the random access file. Even you can read the data using the random access file object, or you can write also. So I have created one object, random access file RAF, that is the new random access file. Then you need to just pass the file name. Whatever the name of the file, I am passing that file in a command line argument. So I have used just args of 0. Then we need to pass the mode of the operation. You want to read only reading purpose, you want to just open the file for writing purpose, or just for the both, like read write. I am just opening this particular file in a read write mode. So now here we can read as well as we can write the data. So now I am just using a long variable position, that is equals to raf.length. So here this will return the number of character that is available in this particular file. So that is our value of the position. Now what is the exact program is for? I am just reverse the particular file without using any reverse method. So now suppose if you want to reverse the content, you need to set this file pointer at the end of the file. So here I am using a one for loop is there for integer I is equals to 0, that position is not equals to 0, and I plus plus, right? I am just setting the seek pointer. I am using the seek pointer that will set the file pointer to position minus 1. That means at the end of the file. Why minus 1? Because our index is start with the 0. So that's why I am setting the end of the file. Now here I am creating the byte b, that raf.read byte. So whatever the character is there, I am just convert it into the byte and store in a B, and then system.out.println, I am just printing the variable in the form of the character, then position minus minus, so the second last character will be printed. So that's why my condition is like position is not equals to 0, initial value of the position, that is the total length of the our file, and then I am decrementing that value of the position in my for loop. So let's run this particular file. So you can easily understand our file name is RAF demo. So Java C RAF demo dot Java and Java RAF demo. And we need to pass one command line argument. I am passing the same path a.txt. In that particular file, the content is hello Ankit Patel. So here the content will be displayed in the reverse form. You can see the first one, that is a Patel, L is print, then E, then T, then P. That is a totally reverse of the hello Ankit Patel. So this is the advantage of the random access file. Suppose if you want to create this type of program for the reader and writer, you are not able to set this file pointer. At that time, you need to use just another logic. But this is the easiest way to set the file pointer. And you can set the file pointer using the seek method and just pass the value accordingly. And the last example, that is reading the data from the web. Now, as I told you, we required one package, that is a import java.network package is there. And that is URL, that is a part of network package, and import java.io package for the buffer input reader and buffer reader. So I am using a URL class. In URL, I am passing the exact URL of the whatever the file that you want to read. I am passing just www.google.com/index.html. So this will not display our Google home page, but this will display the our view source. Just right click on the any web page and just right click on it and just click on view source. So this will print our source file content. So now here I am using input stream reader. Input stream reader, new input stream reader, that is url.openstream. Now url.openstream method we are passing as an argument in the input stream reader method. Then we are using a buffer reader. Now we are storing this particular file in a buffer. So I am just writing like this. Buffer reader in is just new buffer reader ISR. I am using buffer reader just because I just want to use a read line method. Because if you are using or not using a buffer reader, you are using only input stream reader. At the same time, the data are read in the form of the byte, not in the form of the whole line. So I want to just read the whole line at a time. That's why I am putting this input stream reader object into the buffer reader. Okay, so that is, otherwise you are not don't want to use the buffer reader, you cannot you can directly avoid this. So I am using a string, that line is goes through in dot read line is not equals to null, and just system.out.println line. Let's run this code. You can easily understand Java C demo.java. So if you want to run this particular file, you required a internet on your PC. So that then this will display the, you can see the output. This is the not exactly our home page. This is the show the content of the when you are clicking right click on the Google page, then just click on the view source. I am just see you here, the Google page is there. You just click on right click and just click on view source. So this will be display in my output of the Java file. Okay, so this is our output of the Java file. So hope you understand the three program that I have explained in this particular video. So this is the end of the programming session. So thank you very much. If you have any doubt, you can feel free to ask me. Thank you very much.